गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी बिगिन विथ चैप्टर टू, दैट इज़ अकाउंटिंग फॉर पार्टनरशिप फर्म्स फंडामेंटल्स। टुडेज टॉपिक इज इंटरेस्ट ऑन पार्टनर्स ड्रॉइंग्स। यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ ड्रॉइंग्स। ड्रॉइंग्स मीन्स द अमाउंट दैट द पार्टनर विड्रॉज फ्रॉम द फर्म फॉर हिज पर्सनल यूज। दीज ड्रॉइंग्स कैन बी इररेगुलर ड्रॉइंग्स और रेगुलर ड्रॉइंग्स। इररेगुलर ड्रॉइंग्स मीन्स ड्रॉइंग्स ऑफ सेम अमाउंट और डिफरेंट अमाउंट्स एट इररेगुलर इंटरवल्स। द अमाउंट कैन बी सेम और डिफरेंट, बट इट हैज़ टू बी at irregular intervals. Irregular intervals means, like we take the accounting year, that is from 1st April to 31st March, the partner can make the drawing on 1st April or 31st May or 15th June or any other date he wish to draw the amount. Regular drawings means drawings of same amount at regular intervals. Regular intervals means either in the beginning of the month or in the beginning of the quarter or in the end of the quarter, any time, but it has to be a regular interval. Okay, interest on irregular drawings can be calculated from two methods, that is simple method and product method. The formula for interest on drawings will be drawings multiplied by rate upon 100 multiplied by time upon 12 when the period is taken for 12 months in months, and if it is in days then it is taken divided by 365. Here we take an example for the simple method. We have given the dates, amounts. We have to take the number of months up to 31st March, okay? And the interest will calculate. Like on May 1st, the partner has withdrawn rupees 2000. On August 1, rupees 5000. On September 30th, rupees 2000 again. On January 31st, 6000. And on March 31st, rupees 2000. Total amount he has withdrawn is rupees 17000. Now, how many months are left after the first drawing has been made? That is on May 1st up till 31st March. We are considering the accounting period, that is from 1st April to 31st March, and the partner has withdrawn rupees 2000 on May 1st. So, how many months are left after May 1st? 11 months. Likewise, after August 1st up till 31st March, August, September, October, November, December, January, February and March. How many months? 8. Then 6 months, 2 months and 0 months, because the last drawing was made on March 31st. So no month is left after that date. Now how will we calculate interest on drawings? We know the formula, that is the total drawings multiplied by rate. Rate here, rate is 15%. Percent means divided by 100. Multiplied by these 11 months and divided by 12, that is the total months in the year. So when we'll solve it, we'll get rupees 275. Likewise, we'll calculate the other interest on drawings. Method is product method. We have taken the same example, again the same dates and the same amounts and the same months that are left after the drawings. What we'll do here is we'll multiply the amount from the number of months, that is 2000 multiplied by 11 will get 22000, 5000 multiplied by 8 will get 40000, and likewise the total drawings will be 86000. Now we'll apply the formula for interest on drawings, that is the total drawings 86000 multiplied by 15%, that is the rate, and we'll calculate it for 1 month. Will get the same amount 1075 that we got for the simple method. Now we come to the calculation of interest on drawings for the regular drawings. The formula will be interest on drawings is equal to total drawings. Total drawings means if we have given, the partner has withdrawn rupees 2000 per month for 1 year. So 2000 multiplied by 12, that is 24000 will be the total drawings, multiplied by rate upon 100 and multiplied by average time divided by 12. In irregular drawings we got only time, but in regular drawings we have average time. Now how will we calculate average time? Average time is calculated by the formula time left after first drawing plus time left after last drawing divided by 2. Now we'll see some situations when we have to calculate average time under regular intervals of drawings. We'll take the accounting period from 1st April to 31st March. Now we suppose the partner has withdrawn the money at the beginning of the month, like on 1st April, 1st May or 1st June till 1st March. He has withdrawn all the money on the first day of the month. Okay, so the formula was months left after the first drawings, that is 1st April. We have made the first drawing on 1st April. The months are left after the 1st April is 12 months, and the months left after 1st March is 1 month only divided by 2, that is 6.5 months. Then we come to, if the partner withdraws the money in the middle of the month, that is on 15th April or 15th May, then 15th June up till 15th March. So how many months are left after 15th April? 11.5. And how many months are left after 15th March? Half month, that is 0.5. Divided by 2 will get 6 months. Is if the partner has withdrawn the money at the end of the month, that is on 30th April, 31st May, 30th June up till 31st March. So how many months are left after the first drawing? 11 months. And how many months left after the last drawing? No months are left after the last drawing, that is 0. Divided by 2 will get 5.5 months. Now we'll see for quarters. You know the meaning of quarter. A quarter contains 3 months, and in a year we have 4 quarters. So if the partner is making the drawing in the beginning of each quarter, that the first drawing is made on 1st April, then after 3 months 1st July, then after 3 months 1st October, then after 3 months 1st January. So how many months are left after the first drawing? 12 months. And how many months are left after the last drawing? That is 3 months. Divided by 2 will get 7.5 months.